Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss using acetylides as strong nucleophiles in SN2 reactions. The SN2 reaction. The most important feature in an SN2 reaction is a strong nucleophile. When you learned about SN2 reactions, you likely saw lots of strong nucleophiles. Azide, cyanide, alkoxides, etc. I tend to divide SN2 nucleophiles into two categories. The great nucleophiles, like azide, anion, and cyanide, and the sulfides, often called thiolates, those all can do SN2 reactions on primary or secondary halides. The good nucleophiles, like alkoxides, the oxygen anions, are more basic and best used on primary halides. With secondary halides, you'll get mostly E2 products. Let's now turn our eyes towards acetylides. We make acetylides by deprotonating terminal alkynes with sodium amide, NaNH2. The resulting acetylide while electron-rich, like a strong nucleophile, is also basic. So acetylides are nucleophiles that are best used with primary halides for the SN2 reaction. Acetylides are good nucleophiles. Let's put them in our box up here. They are not great nucleophiles. Once we have our acetylide, we can react it with a primary halide. To do an SN2 reaction. Let's make that R prime. SN2 alkylation of acetylides is a great method for building up larger alkyne molecules. Note that this reaction is overall a lot like another reaction called the Williamson ether synthesis on the bottom line of the screen. In that reaction, we start with an alcohol. Here's our alcohol, and we'll deprotonate this alcohol with our special base, sodium hydride, so that gives us an alkoxide. Then, step two, we will add a primary halide and do our SN2 reaction to form a new ether. The reactions are clearly different, but operationally, first step deprotonate, and then second step alkylate in an SN2 reaction. These two reactions, the acetylide alkylation and the Williamson ether synthesis, are closely related. Okay, we now know about acetylides and can add them to our collection of good nucleophiles for SN2 reactions.